Okay, now as I said, there is local and remote node. In portable, you don't have a remote node. There is no node concept at all in the first place. In your LFCS, you can have in LFCS also you don't have node. Remote node concept. Okay, you have nodes, but there is no remote node concept. Starting from your KFCS, you have remote nodes, wherein you can have 4 remote nodes and 6. Local nodes. Okay, so that was what I was talking about, the 10 nodes that KFCS could have. Out of these 10, 6 can be local and 4 can be remote. And in your FFCS, as I said, there was one mother unit and 3 nodes, right? These 3 nodes could be used as remote node or local node, either ways. And in your FFCS large, there were 13 nodes and one mother node. Of these 13 nodes, 6 can be used as local and rest 8 could be used as remote. So these are the configuration details. Now there are several cases that are possible within each of these. Now I'm going to just stick on to the IO cards, because nobody uses nests these days. They normally, you know, go for, you know, FFCS and FFCS large. Okay. Nest is a very archaic concept. The handling capacity is less. Unless you are going for a very small activity, probably you can go for PFCS. Okay. So, but otherwise, when you have large number of IO signal coming days and people just jumping on to, you know, concepts like field bus and things like that, where they want things to be smart, they normally stick to FFCS and FFCS large. So we have this IO cards. We don't have nests anymore. According to me, I stick to that belief. Okay, so let's start with IO cards. In IO cards, as I said, several cases are possible, like with local and remote nodes coming into picture. Okay, always there would be a mother unit. Now this mother unit could be followed by a remote unit or a local unit. Okay, these are the there are 3 possibilities. That is, you have one mother, one local, okay, and followed by a couple of locals. So that is one scenario. Another is one mother followed by local followed by remote, or mother, local, local, remote, like that. It could go on in this manner, right? And the third scenario is mother and just a remote. There is no local at all. Now, thing that we have to understand is, like, whenever a remote node comes into place, okay, we have a different sort of cabling between your parent and child. See, in this case, parent could be anything. This parent could, like, that's when the scenarios, you know, come into picture. Like, if it is just one mother followed by one remote, then your mother is your actual mother. That is your parent FCS, where your processor is present. That is your mother. See, be it any scenario, be it this scenario or the second scenario, where your mother is present followed by a local followed by a remote. So for this remote, this local is the mother, right? Because that is an immediate contact. It is a series structure. Okay, so what happens is, like, the cable that is used to connect your remote node and whatever is present on the other side, that is your actual FCS or your other local node, or maybe even a remote node, whatever is present on this side, it is connected through the extended remote bus. Alright, in other cases wherein just a local is involved, there are numerous other cables that may be involved. Okay, they use extended serial bus, ESP. It is totally dependent on the configuration. But one thing that I am trying to suggest over here is that if there is a remote involved, okay, be it the parent unit, which is your immediate local neighbor, or your actual mother, they should contain a unit which is compatible with your remote. Okay. What I'm trying to say is that it should use a communication unit. Okay. See, so far we have covered IO units, healthcare, we have said there is a processor unit, then there is a power supply unit. But apart from these, when you have multiple units coming up, like you have, we were so far, you know, talking about 13 units. So if you have to communicate between them, there should be something which does the communication, right? So you have a communication unit also. So your mother will have a communication unit from which a cable will come. It will connect to your local, okay? And it will also have a communication unit. From there, again, connection will go to the next node. From there on to the next node. So there are units that are present in each of these nodes. All right. So when a remote node comes into place, the type of communication unit used is different. Okay. There are different model numbers, but you have to understand that if something has to communicate to a remote node, it needs a separate communication unit. For local communication, there is a different unit. For a remote communication, there is a different unit. Okay. Yeah, so I think we have covered the most important parts. I'll just brief out on a couple of important things. Okay. You might hear jargons in the coming series like ESB, which is like extended serial busboard bus. It is used for communication. Its speed is 128 Mbps. Okay. Then you might hear RIO, which is a remote input output bus. Its speed is 31.25 Kbps. Then another jargon that you would hear is ER bus, which is extended remote bus. Its speed is 10 Mbps, and its length, that is how far it can be used, is up to 2 kilometers. Okay.